A tourist's family is blaming a white-tailed spider bite for claiming both his legs. The father of two was forced to undergo two emergency amputations to save his life.
Terry Pareja in the fight of his life, one that his family believes was caused by a spider bite. Terry came to Australia from the Philippines to visit his sister and her husband Ray at their Western Victorian farm, but soon became ill.
On Saturday, his foot started to swell. By Sunday, it was turning black, and on Monday, it was amputated, and his spleen was removed and part of his bowel.
Doctors at Horsham Hospital sent him to Melbourne, where his other leg had to be removed. Terry is suffering from a flesh-eating bacteria, but his family says a local doctor told them it may be the result of a bite from a white-tailed spider.
And they said it was a spider bite, but because they had no other way it could enter. It had to come through a bite.
But experts are doubtful.
Unlikely, considering the number of people that do present to hospital with spider bite, and none of them end up in this particular sort of scenario.
A long-term study found many conditions blamed on spider bites actually had other causes, such as golden staph or infected ulcers.
It may never actually be established whether the man was bitten by a white-tailed spider because there's no test for it. But there's no doubt over the fact that he took simply too long to get medical treatment.
If you, for whatever reason, don't feel well, go to hospital, go to the GP, let them make that decision.
Terry's family has been told he might have to stay in hospital up to 18 months. Ray says he'll do whatever's needed financially to support his brother-in-law.
I think he's selling the house because there's no way I want him to go back to the Philippines.
Brett McLeod, Nine News.